You don't know. Okay, let me ask you something. You look at this sign right here. Let me show you something on this sign. Hey, bro, this is for you too, bro. You look on this sign. You look for a so-called American black man. You'll be going to tribe of Judah, sister. Now, how we can identify this through the curse of the Bible. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 46. How we can identify this curse of the Bible. Look at this. Is the curse a good thing or a bad thing? It's a bad thing, right? Look at our people. Look at the condition of our people. We the greatest nation on the planet. Nobody can beat us in anything, right? But why are we at the bottom? That's a curse. You see what I'm saying, Sue? That's a curse. Now, we finna explain some of the curses that we're going through that the Bible prophesied. Give me verse 15.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15.
Uh-huh.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
The Bible said if we don't listen to the voice of the Lord our God. Hey, brother, this for y'all too. He said the Bible said if we don't listen to the voice of our God. Read on.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
Now, out of the whole sentence, it said to observe, to do. Do is an action word, so if we don't do all his commandments, we don't.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses,
he said, if we don't do, God said, if we don't do what he said to do, all these curses, read on,
shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
He said, shall come upon us and overtake us. Hey, big brother.
Hey, bro.
How you doing, man?
All right.
You doing all right?
Yeah, I'm good, bro.
Huh?
Yeah,
I see you got Fred G on your shirt.
Yeah, Fred G, man.
Hey, man, you know what you're doing right now, though?
Yeah.
What you doing? You know? I know you don't want to read that up.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7 and verse 3. Thou shalt not make marriages with them.
Hey, brother, the Bible says you're supposed to make marriages with them. That's why she said she don't want to hear that mess. Read on.
Thy daughter, thou shalt not give unto his son.
He said, our daughter, we shouldn't give to that son. Read on.
Nor his daughter shalt thou take unto thy son.
And why should we do that?
For they will turn away thy son from following me.
See, because that's what happened when we messed with the other nation.
Yeah.
We're going to turn our children going to turn away from our Most High God.
That's right.
See, the thing is, I'm going to tell you what's crazy. Every other nation teach their children how to be racist. Why do we don't teach our children how to be racist?
Right.
Teach our children to love everything going by.
Right.
of American society, because they've been telling us that we're African American.
Africa come from Leo Scipio Africanus.
That's right.
Which fought against our brothers in the Punic War. America come from America Vespucci, which is Italian navigators. Those are two white men.
That's
you
right.
Don't derive from two white men. So guess what? You got to come from somewhere. So we bring your nationality back. That's what we're trying to break down.
That's right.
All everything that you've been learning, sister, they've been teaching you lies.
Bring it out, Oz.
But here today, sister, you don't know who you are. Thus that Lord. Give me verse 68.
Verse 68.
Uh-huh.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall bring thee to each of us again with ships.
Now, I know you're hearing these scriptures coming out, but the thing is, the Bible is read precept upon precept. That's how you break the Bible down. See, a lot of our people don't understand. They said, read that scripture over again, brother.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
He said, the Lord's going to bring us into Egypt again with ships. How do we get over to America, sister? On ships. But he said he's going to bring us to Egypt again with ships. Hey, brother, you Hispanic brother. This for him too. That's our brother too. He don't even know he our brother. They walk around here like they don't care about Negroes either. But guess what? We gotta go get them to go back to the kingdom.
Right.
But we trying to raise them up too. They ain't got to hear the Most High God gonna start opening their ears up in the last day, so we ain't got to worry about this. But he said the Lord gonna bring us back into Egypt again with ships. Egypt has a meaning, sir. We finna go get that meaning for you. You got that fucking Exodus 22. Now, pay attention, sister. He said, we left about Egypt the first time we walked. So he said, the second time he's going to bring us back with ships. Let's find out what Egypt is. Read that.
I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
He said, he the Lord our God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt. Read that again.
Out of the house of bondage.
So Egypt means bondage, which is slavery, sister. Now, this is not literal Egypt. This is spiritual Egypt.
That's right.
We can go get that in the Bible. Give me that Revelation 11 and 8 right
there. Revelation chapter 11, verse 8.
Uh-huh.
And the dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city.
See, he said, our dead bodies shall lie in the great city. Ain't they shooting us down in the street? Ain't it black on black crime here in the street? So our dead bodies are laying in the great city. This ain't no other country on the world right now is greater than the United States. Read on.
Which spiritually...
Which is what?
Spiritually...
Uh-huh.
Is called Sodom and Egypt.
Because now we live in spiritual Sodom. Now go back. We spiritually live in Sodom and Egypt right now. So we spirit. This is spiritual Egypt right now. This is the same cap. This is a worse captivity than when we was in Egypt.
That's right. Right.
Read the rest of that up.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall bring thee into slavery again with ships.
He said, now the Lord gonna bring us into slavery again with ships. What only race of people that done that? That was us, right? You see what I'm saying? So when you getting to trying to find your nationality. Sister, that was our homeland. We wasn't gonna see our homeland no more again. What's our homeland? No, Africa's not the homeland. We can go get it for you, sister. Read that up.
The book of Galatians, chapter 4, and verse 26.
Uh-huh.
But Jerusalem.
But what?
But Jerusalem.
That's our homeland, sister. Read on.
Which is above its free.
Which is the top state on the planet. It's above its free. That's the new Jerusalem. That's the kingdom, sister. Read on.
Which is the mother of us all.
That's the mother of us all. It's not Africa, sister. It's Jerusalem. You get that? All right, refresh this.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
Uh-huh.
And there ye shall be sold.
He said, when we get up off the spaceship, we were sold. Nigga, sold to Master Johnson down there in Mississippi. Nigga, sold down there to Master Chester down there in South Carolina. When we not sold on the spaceship, this was up. Read on.
There ye shall be sold.
Uh-huh.
Unto your enemies.
He said, we were sold to our friends.
Unto your enemies.
Listen, we said we were going to be sold to our enemies. We didn't make that up. So the people, who were we sold to? The so-called white people. And what did the Bible call them out?
Unto your enemies. enemies.
Us to our enemies. That's what the Bible said. We didn't make that up. So when these so-called white people, and they ask us who was our enemies, who's going at them? Read the rest of that.
For bond men,
for slave men,
and bond women,
and slave women,
and no man shall buy you.
As he said, no man can buy us out of this condition. No man can save us out of this condition. It's an old Quaker term. It's a meaning nobody can save us out of this condition. Marcus Garvey tried, Malcolm X tried, all these different so-called black leaders that we supposed to have, they tried to save us out of what they did. We still in the same condition. So what can change us? This is God's law. But God said we was going to be discontinued from our heritage. Give me Jeremiah 17:4 right quick, God. Give me Deuteronomy 28. Give me verse 52. I'm going to show sister something that's happening here in America. Read that out.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17 and verse 4. And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thy heritage.
See, that's the reason why you don't know who you are, sister. Because the Bible prophesied that we was going to be discontinued from our heritage, sister. That's why you don't know. See, because we didn't know either. And so the Most High God took the blindness off our eyes and took the muzzles out of our ears.
That's right.
Started giving us understanding of His Bible, sister.
That's
when
right.
We started giving His understanding. Now we know where we come from and who we are. And we can go to the description. We can go to the scriptures and identify who we are. And if you come and get with us, sister, what the brother was bringing out, sister, we can help build you up and show you. You can teach your children, sister, if you got some children. And you can see some of your family, some of them didn't want to hear, because everybody's not going to accept this truth. Read on up.
That I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve thine enemy.
Who we work for?
Thine enemy.
And so he said, we have called us to serve our enemy. Don't we get up and go to work for the so-called white man in these other nations? We get up, guess what? The white people catch the bus for pleasure. We catch the bus for what? To go to work. That's what the Bible says. I'm going to show you something, what's happening to our brothers, the so-called Hispanics. Read verse 28, 52.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 52.
Uh-huh.
And he shall eat the fruit of thy land. I'm sorry, Salakia. And he shall besiege thee in all thy gates.
He said he's going to surpass us. He's going to be surrounding us in all our gates. Read on.
Until thy high and fenced wall.
What is Donald Trump trying to build?
Until thy high and fenced wall. Besiege thee and all thy gates throughout all thy land.
And that's what he's doing. He's going down in Mexico destroying them brothers, taking their children. But they just now going public, which they've been doing that for years.
Mm-hmm.
They've been taking them people's children. How they feel? How would you feel if they come taking your children? They did the same thing to your ancestors. But see, the thing is, guess what? They never talk about this. Over 90 million so-called blacks came over here on slave ship and died, sister, on boats. There was men and women laying on top of each other, women having menstruals all over each other, all over the men, all over babies. Women having babies on top of each other in their boats, and they were killing them, sister, because they wasn't making it over here. This is our heritage. How you doing, brother? This is our heritage. This is what they done to us. They treated us like dogs. But here we are. We waking up in the last day showing our people celebrate Thanksgiving, guess what? You celebrate the slaughter of the Native American Indians. They killed over 70 million Indians. They gave us smallpox blankets. They gave their brothers blankets with diseases in them to kill them brothers off. If they couldn't do that, they was killing the buffalo. Well, all the buffalo that was in the United States. Then it wasn't the land of the buffaloes roam. Where the buffaloes at now? But now, guess what they doing? They destroyed all the buffalo. They tried to destroy the Native American Indians. But guess what? Some of us, some of y'all could be Indians. Some of them just could be your forefathers or your foremothers. See, but we don't know that because we've been discontinued from our heritage. And we don't. But we're trying to get back to God's laws. That's the only way. Because every great black leader that we had, they failed us. Give me Deuteronomy 28, verse 48. Every black leader we had, he failed us. Marcus Garvey, Malcolm X,
Who else? Malcolm X, Martin Luther King. Martin Luther King said, but he told us to join hand in hand with him. But the Most High God never told us. He told us to divide. He divided us. Give me divide the nation. Test. He told us to divide the nation. We just bring the loudspeaker out because we want people to listen all over. You know, the thing is, we're down for the edification of all our brothers. So we're hoping that all our brothers and sisters wake up in the last day. See, the thing is, we don't just come teach y'all that. We teach our family. We teach the laws of the Most High God. That's the only way we're going to make it back to the kingdom. Read it up.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32, and verse 8.
Uh-huh.
When the Most High divided to the nation their inheritance.
See, when he said, when he divided the nation. See, the thing is, we never were supposed to be a part of them, the other nation. We was divided from the beginning. Read. When
he separated.
See, when Martin Luther King told us to join hand in hand, our God told us never to even come with these people. He said, we should give our children to them. They should give their children to us. Because these other nations will take us away from our God.
That's right.
So why do you think that it's cool that we could be 50-50? Hey, sister, call us, sister. All right. Why you think we keep telling our brothers and sisters, look, repent and come back to the Most High God? Because guess what? All these black leaders we had, we still in the same condition. We still got to catch the bus line like all the rest of the Negroes to go to work.
That's
guess
right.
What? And white people get the bus line to do what? To have fun. Having a good time. Look at them brothers downtown. I know y'all done seen them. But look at the white people downtown. They having a good time. That's two different type of things that's going on. See, but we love the gift that the American Hill gave us.
Right.
That's these dollar bills. But we want the kingdom. We don't want their money. We want the kingdom, brother. Read.
When he separated the sons of Adam,
uh-huh.
He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel.
To the number of the children of Israel. Hey, brother, I'm asking something. Is your father so-called black man? I know that's the term they gave, but we're going to give you the term what the Most High God gave you, though. Is he so-called black man? That's why I said so-called. So he's a so-called black man? Well, you be from the tribe of Judah. What tribe your wife from? I mean, her father so-called black man, too? Y'all both be from the tribe of Judah. Did y'all know a great man came from the tribe of Judah? Give me Hebrews chapter 7. We're going to show y'all who this great man came from the tribe of Judah. You got some more on there? Okay. We're going to show y'all who came from the tribe of Judah. The greatest man that ever walked the planet came from that same old tribe, man. And we're going to show y'all. Got that up? 7 and 14.
Great. The book of Hebrews, chapter 7, verse 14.
Uh-huh.
For it is evident
uh-huh.
that our Lord sprang out of Judah.
He said, this is evident. When it's evident, that means it's sure that the Lord sprang out of Judah. So that means the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, he came out the tribe of Judah. See, the thing is, brother, we up here trying to wake up in the last day to tell our people, guess what? We got royal blood through our veins, man. We the greatest nation on the planet. Who can beat us in anything, man? He only gave this Bible to us. Give me Psalms 119, verse 59. He only gave this Bible to us, but a lot of people don't like the other nations. They don't want to hear this. That this Bible's only for them. That's why they can't stand up here and let us teach them the Bible, because this thing destroys them, man. They hate to hear this. 119 verse 59. Okay, then. Right on. Give me that.
The book of Psalms, chapter 147, verse 19.
Uh-huh.
He showeth his word unto Jacob.
See, now Jacob is the father of these 12 tribes, which is y'all brothers and y'all brothers and sisters. All of us, we are a part of the 12 tribes of Israel. He gave us the word. That means he gave us the Bible. Read.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
Uh-huh.
He had not dealt so with any nation.
What's that mean, brother? That means this Bible is only given to us.
So the thing is, the other nation might not like it, but it's the Bible. So if they don't like it, tell them, you know what we always tell them? Take it up with God. Because God sent it. We didn't make that up.
Freeze this.
As for his judgments, they have not known them.
They don't know our God, man. These people don't. They don't know our God. He only gave this Bible for us. It's for us, by us. Like the FUBU effect. This Bible was only given to our people, man. Read.
Praise ye the Lord.
Yeah, praise ye the Lord. And can we give all praise to the Most High for giving us this word? Because get now, in these last days, we ain't got to stay back. Yeah, I'm glad they talking to us. We ain't got to stay back. You know what I'm saying? And we ain't got to stay back and sit on our hands anymore. The real man of Israel, we standing up, man. We bringing our children. We bringing our wives. We showing them. Hey, brothers and sisters, this is for y'all too. This Bible is for y'all, man. We out here for our people, man. We out here to answer any question, bro. You got any questions?
Pretty much everything y'all telling me.
Wisdom came first, brother. You're definitely right. Wisdom come first.
Okay, now. I love the way y'all break it down, because I've been studying y'all on YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
Because when other people interpret it, this same book, it doesn't fit in like a piece of puzzle in the way that you explain.
That's right.
This is what I want to know right here.
Uh-huh. And it's for y'all brothers and sisters, too. Y'all stick around, man. Y'all got any questions? We can answer y'all questions, man.
This is what I want to know right here.
Uh-huh.
I started that book because a lot of people don't believe that book. How can we prove that we belong to the 12 tribes of Israel?
Outside this book, brother, this the only thing we lean on, brother. We lean on the Bible. There's no other book got prophecies that the Bible has. There's no other book can stand up to this Bible. There's no other book that can say something's gonna happen 3,000 years later and it happened. But this Bible did. Let me get Zechariah 11:5 right quick. I'm gonna show you a prophecy in the Bible. That this Bible had came. Let me show you something right quick. This is a prophecy that'll tell you. It's just one of the prophecies. This Bible has many prophecies.
What's that, y'all? All right,
wait a minute. The book of Zechariah, chapter 11, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
Whose possessor slay them and hold themselves.
Hold up. He said, whose possessor slay them? Who's slaying us down in the street? These so-called cops slaying us in the streets, right? Read.
And hold themselves not guilty.
Did you know that was in the Bible? That's crazy. That the Bible said that they was going to be shooting us down in the street and holding themselves not guilty. That's a prophecy, brother, that the Bible brought forth. Let me get this right quick. I'll read that.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 34 and verse 16.
Uh-huh.
Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read.
See, the thing is, the Bible told us to seek him out the book of the Lord. See, the thing is, they done touched, they read, they used to read us the Bible. We wasn't allowed to read. But now, guess what? Those chains are broken off us. Why are we not reading now? Give me Revelation 1 and 3. Those chains are broken off us. We're able to read now. So guess what? We finna go in here and read this Bible and see what it really saying. Because this Bible condemns the so-called white man. This Bible condemns the so-called Chinese man. This Bible, it's 18 nations in the Bible. This Bible condemns 17 nations and only chose one, which is us, which are the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
Read that.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 34, verse 16.
Uh-huh.
Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read.
Uh-huh.
No one of these shall fail.
Uh-huh.
None shall want her mate.
No Bible can stand up against this Bible. No Bible can mate with this Bible. No book from any religion can stand up to this Bible. What other book in the world can stand up to the Bible? The thing is, this is what they tell us, that the laws are done away with. Read half the book, then y'all can get to understand it. No.
Give me Psalms 40 and 7. Read this out.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 3.
Uh-huh.
Blessed is he that readeth.